There are few people who do what he has done.
N'abantu bakeya bakora ibyo amaze gukora.
To build this.
Kubaka ibintu nk'ibi.
This in any part of the world.
Kubaka ibintu nk'ibi muri ino si yacu.
It's a big thing.
Ni ikintu gikomeye cyane.
Ah, it's a good place to clap. Oh. This building in any part of the world.
Inyubako muri ino si yacu.
It's a big thing.
Ni ikintu gikomeye cyane.
And we want to thank God that the man of God and his wife were faithful.
Turashimira Imana kubwo umubyeyi wacu n'umufasha we arabizerwa.
To obey God.
Kumvira Imana.
To do this.
Kugira ngo bakore ibi ngibi.
Amen.
Amen.
I want you to appreciate him better than you have done by putting your hands
together. Amashyi birenze uko mwabikoze.
This morning I talked briefly from my book, Spiritual Fathers and Sons, and how to work the relationship, the wisdom to work the relationship.
Iki gitondo navuzeho gakeya ku buryo ubusabane bw'umwana n'umubyeyi mu gitabo cyanjye
nandi. I was just in chapter 1 and 2.
Navuze igice cya mbere gusa n'icya kabiri.
I couldn't do more than that.
Ntabwo nari gukora ibirenze ibyo ngibyo.
But if you understand the role of spiritual fathers in your life,
ariko uramutsumenye ubushobozi bw'umubyeyi w'umwuka mu buzima bwawe.
Things happen.
Ibintu biba mu buzima bwawe.
And if you understand the role of being a son,
ushoboye kumenya ububasha bwo kuba umwana.
Things happen.
Ibintu bihaba.
Not everybody who attends the church is a son.
Ntabwo abantu bose baza mu itorero ari abana.
And so get this book.
Rero muze kugura ibi bitabo.
Because tonight,
kuko uyu mugoroba,
I'm going to take you into your blessing.
Ndabinjiza mugisha wanyu.
Because if you are going to be able to consecrate your life effectively to your master as a disciple,
kugira ngo uhu buzima bwawe witange ku buzima bwawe ku mwami wawe,
there is a certain place you must come from. There is a journey you must make.
Hari ahantu ugomba kubuvuye.
And these four times I'm sharing,
ibi bintu ngiye kuvuga,
I'm taking you on a specific journey.
Urugendo ngiye kubinjizamo.
We started with looking at sonship.
Twatangiye tureba umwana mu mwuka.
I'm taking you into your blessing.
Hanyuma none nashaka kubinjiza mu mugisha w'umwana.
There's a book I wrote.
Hari igitabo nanditse.
After teaching 12 Sundays.
Maze kwigisha ibyumweru 12.
On curses and blessings.
Mvuga ku mugisha n'umuvumo.
I decided
nahisemo
that I'll put it together.
Kuzabishyira hamwe.
Because pastors,
kuko abashumba,
began to call me and say, Bishop, when we watched your series on television,
batangiye kumpamagara bambwira ngo igihe twakurikije inyigisho zawe kuri televiziyo, umurimo nkora warahindutse.
Businessmen and women called me.
Abacuruzi barampamagaye.
We watched your series on television.
Twakurikije inyigisho zawe kuri televiziyo. Ubuzima bwacu bwarahindutse.
And so tonight,
uyu mugoroba,
we just want to scratch the surface of.
Ndifuza ko dukoraho gakeya ku byo nanditse muri icyo gitabo.
Get from the place of the curse to the place of the blessing.
Tuva ahantu h'umuvumo twinjira mu mugisha.
Lift up one hand as a sign of surrender to God.
Uzamura ikiganza cyawe nk'uburyo bwo kwiyegurira Imana.
Heavenly Father, it's time to
mu izina rya Yesu.
It's time to declare your word.
Ni igihe cyo kuvuga ijambo ryawe.
The word is already anointed.
Ijambo ryawe rirasizwe.
Lord, even as I stand on this platform.
Mpagaze aha hantu.
That your servant and handmaiden you've helped them to raise as an altar to you. Lord, I join my faith with their faith. And I ask that the grace of this house will avail to work in the lives of your people. In Jesus' name. Give me a believing amen. Hallelujah. A lot of the times when you talk to believers and you talk about curses, immediately they start telling you, stop it. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Being made a curse for us. For cursed is everyone that hangs on the trees. And so Jesus went to the cross. So we are free. It is true. And it is not fully true.
Ariko ntabwo ari ukuri kuzuye.
Amen. Let me scratch the surface of something.
Beka ngira ibintu mvugaho.
That really happened.
Byabaye.
So many years ago,
imyaka yashize,
there were these two people who lived.
Hari abantu babiri babayeho.
One of them was called Max Jukes.
Umwe yitwaga gutyo.
The other was called Jonathan Edwards.
Undi nawe yitwaga gutyo.
Max Jukes was a very ungodly man.
Wavuze yari umugabo ntiyari umuntu w'Imana.
His wife was very ungodly.
Umugore we yari umuntu utubaha Imana.
Jonathan Edwards was a Christian and a preacher.
Ariko Jonathan yari umuvuga butumwa w'ubaha Imana.
His wife was very very godly.
Umugore we nawe yubahaga Imana.
So many years later,
imyaka myinshi ishize,
they tried to trace their descendants.
Bagerageje gushaka ibi uruhererekane rw'urubyaro rwabo.
They got 500 of Max Jukes' descendants.
Babonye 500 kururiya wa mbere yavuze.
And this is what they found.
Ibi nibyo babonye.
310 of them died as poor people or paupers.
310 muri 500 bapfuye ari abakene.
150 of them became criminals.
150 muri bo bari abanyabyaha bakomeye.
7 of them were murderers.
Abandi bari abasazi.
100 were very known drunkards.
Ijana muri bo bari abasinzi bakomeye.
More than half of the women of his descendants were prostitutes.
Mukinyejana che half igice cyose bari indaya.
Max Jukes' descendants, according to the report, had cost the American government by the 1900s $1.25 million.
Mumwa kajuni na chime magana chenda bavuga ko yahombeje leta umubare w'amafaranga menshi cyane.
When you calculate it in today's currency,
uyashize mu mafaranga y'uyu munsi,
$34 million.
Ni miliyoni 34.
Then they got 1,394 of Jonathan Edwards' descendants.
Hanyuma bajyana no mu kinyejana cya Jonathan.
And this is what they found.
Ibi ni byo babonye.
295 of them
magana 290 muri bo
graduated from university.
Barangije university.
13 became university presidents.
15 babaye abakuru ba za university.
65 became professors.
65 babaye abigisha muri university.
3 were elected US senators.
Batatu bari abasenateri muri America.
3 were state governors.
Batatu bari bakureza baraba guverineri.
Others were sent out as foreign ministers or ambassadors.
Abenshi boherejwe nk'abambasaderi cyangwa abaministri.
30 were judges.
30 bari abacamanza.
100 were lawyers.
Ijana bari abacamanza.
One was the dean of an outstanding law school.
Umwe yarakuriye ishuri rikomeye mu mategeko.
56 practiced as physicians.
56 bari abaganga bakomeye.
One was the dean of a medical school.
Umwe yarakuriye university ikomeye mu buvuzi.
75 became senior military officers.
55 bari mu gisirikare mu nzego zo hejuru.
100 of his descendants were well-known missionaries.
Ijana muri bo bari bazwi nk'abamisiyoneri.
Preachers and prominent authors.
Abavuga butumwa bakomeye.
80 held some form of public office.
80 muri bo bari abantu bakomeye muri biro bya leta.
3 were mayors of large cities.
Bari bafite ubutunzi bukomeye.
One was the controller of the US Treasury.
Umwe yari umuntu ukuriye ubutunzi bwa Amerika.
Another became a vice president of the United States.
Undi muri bo yabaye vice president wa Amerika.
When they checked this family line,
babonye umuryango ubuzima bwawo.
Not one of them
nta numwe muri bo
had even spent from the United States government.
Nta numwe wigeze agira amafaranga twara cyangwa se igihugu kimutangaho. Kubera umuvumo
and blessings.
Hamwe n'umugisha.
When in Europe, I don't know about Rwanda, so I can talk.
Iburayi ariko sinzi mu Rwanda.
But in Europe and many parts of the world,
mu mugabane w'Uburayi ndetse ne mu isi,
when you want to do a health insurance,
yushaka gukora ubwishingizi bw'ubuvuzi,
or buy a building,
cyangwa se ugura inzu,
what they do is they ask your family history.
Bakubaza amateka y'umuryango wawe.
And they ask whether some specific diseases were in your family.
Bakakubaza niba hari indwara zijya zigaragara nk'izi mu muryango wawe.
If they were in your family,
niba zari zindi mu muryango wawe.
The banks see you as a risk.
Bank cyangwa se ubwishingizi buragutinya.
And so they give you a higher premium to pay.
Rero baguha kwishyura amafaranga menshi.
Even the children of this world
ndetse n'abana b'isi
know that that is how it is.
Bazi uburyo umuvu umera.
How many of you have heard of Angelina Jolie?
Ninde muri mwe wumvise Angelina Jolie?
Let me see.
Reka turebe abamwumvise.
Ah, because Apostle is here, don't pretend you don't watch movie.
Ah, reka mwibesha nkaho mutajya mureba amafilime.
How many have heard of Brad Pitt?
Nibande wumvise Brad Pitt?
Okay, Angelina Jolie is the wife of Brad Pitt.
Angelina Jolie ni umugore wa Brad Pitt.
2 years ago, Angelina Jolie had a double mastectomy. Her breasts were cut off. Because there is the doctor said there is a probability she may have cancer because her grandmother died fighting cancer.
Baravuze ngo ashobore kuba yari kanseri kuko nyirakuru umubyara yishwe na kanseri.
Her mother died fighting cancer.
Nyina umubyara yapfuye kubera kanseri.
Her auntie died fighting cancer.
Banyirasenge bapfuye kubera kanseri.
In fact, end of last year, early this year,
umwaka ushize ndetse n'uyu mwaka utangira,
she went to take out her tubes.
Bagiye kumukuramo bimwe mu muri we.
Because the doctor said there's a probability.
Abaganga baravuze ngo birashoboka yuko
she may have ovarian cancer.
Ashobora kuba afite kanseri yo mumara.
I'm talking about in the natural.
Ndavuga mu bifatika.
Hello?
Hello.
So beloved, cases are real.
Bavandimwe imivumira afatika.
If you go into the scriptures,
tujye mu byanditswe,
the word case,
ijambo muvumo,
is mentioned 430 times.
Uvugwa inshuro 130.
Sorry, 160 times.
Ijana na mirongo itandatu.
Anything that is mentioned two times in the Bible,
ikintu kivuzwe birenze kabiri muri Bibiliya,
you have to give attention to it.
Ugomba kukitegereza neza.
So if it's mentioned three times,
niba bivuzwe inshuro eshatu,
you must watch it well.
Ugomba kukitegereza.
This case is mentioned 160 times.
Umu ijambo muvumo rivuga inshuro ijana na mirongo itandatu muri Bibiliya.
And blessing is mentioned 430 times.
Hanyuma umugisha ukavuga inshuro 130.
Hello.
Hello.
Years ago, there is what is called in America the Tippecanoe case.
Muri America bahavuzwe icyo kintu sinacyumvise neza.
Tecumseh case.
Ni icyo ngicyo.
What is the tip? You can Google it.
Mushobora kugishaka kuri internet.
What is the Tippecanoe case?
Icyo ngicyo avuze rica rico.
So many years ago,
imyaka myinshi yashize,
when the Americans, when the European settlers got to America,
igihe abanyaburayi bajyaga muri America,
they fought the Native Americans.
Barwanye n'abanyirubutaka bwo muri America.
And in one particular battle,
mu ntambara imwe barwanaga,
they massacred the Native Americans.
Abo abasangwa butaka bo muri America.
There was a chief called Tecumseh.
Hari umuyobozi witwaga Tecumseh.
And he placed a curse,
hanyuma arabavuma,
on the American government.
Avuma ubuyobozi bwa America.
And said because of what had happened,
kubera ibyabaye,
every year in America where a president was elected and the number ended zero,
buri gihe cyose iyo umuperezida yatorwaga imibare ikarangizwanya na zeru,
that president will die in office.
Uwo muperezida yagwaga mu biro.
It started in 1840.
Byatangiye muri 1840.
Richard Harrison died in office.
Richard Harrison yaguye apfuye ari perezida.
Abraham Lincoln died. Every president that was elected in a year that ended with zero.
Buri mu perezida watorwaga umwaka urangizwa na zero.
Some Christians in prayer got a revelation and went into the archives and found this curse in the archives.
Abakristo batangiye gusenga bagiye mu bushakashatsi mu bubiko basanga iyo mibare ikivuze.
They decided to pray and break the curse.
Batangira gusenga bavunagura umuvumo.
Then President Reagan was elected.
Igihe Perezida Reagan yaratowe.
In a year that ended with zero.
Nawe umwaka agombaga kurangizwa na zero.
After his election, one day he was going to inaugurate a thing in a hotel.
Amaze gutorwa rimwe yaragiye gufungura kumugaragara ikintu muri hotel.
They said that hotel was the most secure hotel.
Baravuga ngo iyo hotel ni irinzwe kuruta izindi zose.
The president went in when he was coming out.
Perezida yinjiramo asohoka.
Somebody shot him.
Umuntu aramurasa.
And the bullet lodged close to his lungs.
Isasu rigenda rijya kugera neza
ku mwijima we. When they took him to the hospital,
bamujyanye kuwa muganga.
The doctor said they don't know how he survived.
Abaganga baravuga ngo ntituzi uburyo yarokotse.
But he survived.
Ariko yarokotse.
And the reason why he survived,
impamvu yarokotse,
was because the Christians had broken that curse.
Nuko abakristo bakuyeho wa muvumo wa mugabo yavuze.
You didn't hear me. I said the Christians had broken that curse.
Navuze ngo abakristo bakuyeho wa muvumo.
Whatever curse is in your family line,
buri muvumo uri mu muryango wawe,
in the name of Jesus,
izina rya Yesu Kristo,
tonight,
uyu mugoroba,
by the power of the Holy Ghost,
imbaraga z'Umwuka Wera,
may it be broken.
Reka
ukuru
umuvumo wawe uhinduke umugisha.
Give me a believing amen.
Niba ubyizera vuga uti amen.
Not quite long.
Nta myaka myinshi ishize.
George Bush
George Bush
was elected in a year that ended with zero.
Yatowe umwaka barangiraga na zero.
People were planning to assassinate him.
Abantu bari batangiye gupanga cyangwa gushyira hamwe uburyo bamwica.
Because the case had been broken.
Kuko umuvumo wari warakuweho.
The report says that they were arrested before they could operate.
Inkuru zivuga yuko babafataga bakiri mu mugambi.
What you see, cases are things that are invoked against you and things that are applied by issue of things that have been done in the past or even in the present.
Umuvumo ni ikintu kiba gihari ariko gikurikiranya amateka yawe gishaka no kwica ejo hawe hazaza.
Every case has a demon behind it.
Kandi buri muvumo ugira umudayimoni uri
inyuma yawe. But in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Ariko mu izina rya Yesu w'i Nazareti.
Every agreement of witches and wizards.
Buri guhuza kose kw'abapfumu.
To make sure any case works against you.
Kugira ngo hagire umuvumo ugukurikirana.
We neutralize it by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Mu izina ry'umwuka wera.
Give me a believing amen.
Uvuge mute amen.
Time will not permit me to prove from scripture to you.
Igere cyanyemera kugira ngo njye mu byanditswe byera mbereke.
But when you go to Israel till today,
ugiye muri Israel n'ubukingo n'ubu.
There is what we call the Mount of Gilboa.
Hari umusozi wa Gilboa.
You remember in 2 Samuel chapter 1.
Muribuka muri Samuel wa kabiri gice cya mbere.
David cursed the Mount of Gilboa.
Dawidi yavumye umusozi wa Gilboa.
Because that is where Saul and Jonathan were slain.
Muribuka kwari ho Jonathan na Sauli bapfiriye.
David said, "May no dew come upon you."
Ngo ntagire ikime kizakugwaho.
May no vegetation grow on you.
Ntagire igihingwa kizakweraho.
Israel is the first nation that was able to change salt water or sea water into drinking water.
Israel nicyo gihugu cyonyine cyashoboye gufata amazi y'umunyu kikahindura amazi yo kunywebwa.
They were the first nation to be able to bring vegetation into the desert.
Nicyo gihugu cyashoboye guhinga mu butayu.
But after 3,000 years since David cursed the Mount of Gilboa.
Nyuma y'imyaka 3,000 kuva David yava mu musozi wa Gilboa.
When you go to Israel,
yuje muri Israel,
all the other mountains are green.
Indi misozi yose ni cyatsi rasa
neza. The Mount of Gilboa is still dry.
Ari musozi wa Gilboa muracyari uracyumye.
Because curses work.
Kuko imivumo irakora.
For 3,000 years that curse is still working.
Imyaka 3,000 ya muvumo uracyahari.
If you are here with me, give me an amen.
Niba uri kumwe nanjye vuga ute amen.
Listen to me, beloved.
Munyumve neza.
There are things that bring curses and there are signs of curses.
Hari ibimenyetso bigaragaza imivumo ukwiza.
How do you know if you are under a curse?
Niko tumenya kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
Let me quickly take you through a few things to make you know that you probably may be under a curse.
Ndakangira ibintu bimwe bice mbereka bituma umenya niba uri munsi y'umuvumo.
If you find yourself going into different directions from where you want to go, you may be under a curse.
Igihe cyose wibona uri mu nzira zitandukanye n'izo wifuzaga kujyamo.
When you suffer barrenness, because the word of God says there shall not be any barren amongst my people. When I talk about barrenness, your physical, your job, your inability to produce in your job, increase, multiply, grow your church, lack of progress, that is all barrenness. When you experience frequent miscarriages or repeated miscarriages, you may be under a curse. When you keep suffering humiliation, the Bible says we should humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. But when you keep suffering humiliation, you may be under a curse. If you keep having breakdown of family relationships,
you komeza kwisanga gukundana n'abantu benshi batandukanye,
suffering defeat,
kandi ugahora uneshwa,
you may be under a curse.
Ushobora kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
If your story is that you almost broke through,
igihe cyose ugiye kubona inzira icamo,
but something went wrong,
hakagira ikintu kibi kihaba,
you may be under a curse.
Ushobora kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
There are students who pass every exam,
hari abanyeshuri batsinda ibizamini byose,
and fail the final exam,
hanyuma icyanyuma bakagitsindwa,
you may be under a curse.
Bishoboke ko ushobora kuri munsi
y'umuvumo. If your life rises and falls,
ubuzima bwawe iyo buzamuka bumanuka,
you may be under a curse.
Ushobora kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
If you keep starting projects,
igihe cyose utangira ama
projects, but you can't complete the project,
ariko ntushobora gusoza umushinga wawe.
Or you don't have the ability to finish it.
Cyangwa se udafite ubushobozi bwo kurangiza uwo mushinga.
Ushobore
kuburi munsi y'umuvumo.
If you work hard,
iyo ukora cyane,
and you have nothing to show for it,
kandi ntagira umusaruro
ukuramo, you put in maximum effort,
ugashyiramo imbaraga zawe zose,
but you get minimum results,
ariko ukabona umusaruro muke,
you may be under a curse,
ushobore kuburi munsi
y'umuvumo, because for you, a child of God,
ukiri umwana w'Imana,
you are supposed to put in minimum effort,
kuko wagombye gushyiramo imbaraga
nke, and get maximum results,
hanyuma umusaruro ukaba mwinshi.
If the Bible says it is not by might,
Bibiliya ivuga ngo si ku bw'imbaraga,
no, it's not by power,
si ku bw'imbaraga,
then it means that by the little effort you put in,
kubw'imbaraga nke washyiramo,
God will take charge and change situations.
Imana itangira gukora.
I came to prophesy into somebody's life,
naje kugira umuntu mpanurira ijoro,
that after this conference,
nyuma y'iki giterane,
whatever you touch,
ibyo uzakoraho byose,
will be blessed,
bizahabwa umugisha.
Give him an amen.
Kuvuga ute amen.
When you keep experiencing regular tragedies,
igukunda guhura nakaga kenshi,
and repeated ones,
ibintu bihora bigaruka,
you may be under a curse,
ushobore kuburi munsi y'umuvumo,
accidents,
impanuka,
and they happen usually on particular days or months of the year,
kandi iyo izo mpanuka zikunda kuba mu minsi runaka n'amezi runaka.
We are entering some months
that
are high on the satanic altar.
Aho igicaniro cya Satani gikomeye
kiba. Because 30th October.
Kuko itariki 10
is Halloween.
Itariki 10 tuzukwa kwacumi.
And in America,
muri America,
Halloween has been proven to be when there are more ritual murders. The police have proven that during Halloween there are more ritual murders than at any time in America.
Munsi wa Halloween muri America bamaze kugaragaza yuko ni munsi uteza akaga n'ibyago bikomeye cyane.
Why? Because from the months of October to December,
kuko mu kwa 10 ugana mu kwa 12,
they are the months that you experience frequent accidents than any other month.
Niho hagaragara ama akomeye cyane kuruta
ndemeze. Because it's a season when satanic altars are raised,
nibwo igicaniro cya Satani kizamuka,
and the spirit of death and tragedy is released,
umwuka w'urupfu n'impanuka zitandukanye.
But this year,
ariko uyu mwaka,
it will be minus you,
bizaba usibye wowe.
You didn't hear. I said this year,
uyu mwaka,
it will be minus you,
bizaba kubanda pana wowe.
You will not die,
ntaguzapfa,
but you will live,
uzabaho,
to declare the works of God.
Imirimo y'Uwiteka.
Give me a believing amen.
Amen.
If you are struggling without correspondent fulfillment,
igihe cyose ugerageza ariko ntugere ku byo wifuza,
you may be under a curse,
ushobore kuburi munsi y'umuvumo.
If there are the reoccurrence of evil things in your life,
niba hari ibintu bibi by'umwijima bijya biba mu buzima bwawe,
you may be under a curse,
ushobore kuburi munsi y'umuvumo.
When you offend those who love you and your friends prove unfriendly, those people you offend them, you even apologize and they don't accept it, you may be under a curse.
Inshuti zawe iyo ugeze iyo uzibabaje mu buryo bumwe, niyo usabye imbabazi bakakwima imbabazi, bishoboke kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
It is a sickness that keeps reoccurring in the family,
niba ari indwara ikomeza yigaragaza mu muryango,
it may be a curse,
ishobore kuba umuvumo.
If as for you, you rise to the top and you fall,
urazamuka wagera hejuru ukongera ukikubita hasi,
you get to grace and you come to grass,
wazamuka mu buntu ukamanuka hasi.
When a ceiling is placed upon your life,
iyo igicu gishizwe hejuru yawe,
you can't lift your head anymore,
ushobora kuzamura umutwe,
you may be under a curse,
ushobore kubona munsi y'umuvumo.
If you come to a place where you don't know what you want out of life,
dimwe na rimwe haraho bigera ukumva utazi icyo ukeneye mu buzima,
you may be under a curse,
ushobora kuba ari ikimenyetso kuri munsi
y'umuvumo. If you keep experiencing a pattern of setbacks,
iyo ukomeza guhura no kuba wasubira inyuma kenshi, ushobore kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
And it is like the whole world has conspired against you,
bigasa nk'aho isi yose yaguhagurukiye,
you may be under a curse,
ushobore kuri munsi y'umuvumo.
Somebody said, and I quote,
reka mvuge ibyo umuntu yavuze,
he said curses act like a fence,
ngo imivumo ikorwa nk'uruzitiro,
they protect evil spirits,
ngo birinda imyuka mibi,
and give them legal grounds to operate,
bikayiha uburenganzira bwo gukora,
and they can come from different sources,
kandi bishobora guturuka mu nzira zitandukanye.
When I started, I made a statement,
ntangira navuze ikintu,
I said when you start talking about curses to Christians,
iyo utangiye kuvuga umuvumo mu bakristo,
a lot of Christians say that we are redeemed from the curse of the
Lord. wacu ngo twakuwe mu muvugo w'abategeko n'icyaha.
A lot of Christians, they know only one curse.
Kuko kuba Kristo bazi umuvumo umwe gusa.
The curse of the law.
Umuvumo w'amategeko.
But beloved, there is more than one curse.
Bavandimwe hari imivumo irenze umwe.
We have the curse of God.
Dufite umuvumo w'Imana.
We have the curse of man or self-imposed curses.
Dufite umuvumo w'abantu cyangwa se wacu ku giti cyacu twivugiye.
Let me give you an example of a self-imposed curse.
Leka mbaho urugero rw'umuvumo wivugiye wowe.
The Bible says,
Bibiliya iravuga,
honor your father and mother.
Ubaha so na nyoko.
That your days may be longer.
Kugira ngo iminsi yawe yiyongere ku isi.
If you dishonor your father and mother,
iyo utumviye ababyeyi bawe,
even though you are saved,
nubwo wabukijijwe,
you cut short your life.
Ubuzima bwawe ubucamo
kwa brought yourself under a self-imposed curse.
Numuvumo wowe ubwawe wishizeho.
You know, New Testament believers, we our liberty, the way we understand it, is different.
Umudendezo w'abisezerano rishya rimwe na rimwe turawurenga.
Let me take you a little journey in the Bible quickly on a self-imposed curse. You remember that Jacob cheated his brother. He brought a self-imposed curse upon himself by cheating his brother. He went to work with his uncle. His uncle cheated him. Seven times what he did. Because a self-imposed curse is also called the curse of seed time and harvest.
Come again.
The curse of seed time and harvest. The Bible says, as long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest will not pass. So if you are even a believer and you sow a bad seed, you will harvest a bad harvest. Am I teaching some Bible? So Jacob's uncle cheats him. David takes somebody's wife, kills the man. God reveals it. He asks for mercy. God forgives him. But David's son sleeps with David's concubines publicly. Because what David did brought a self-imposed curse. David killed
Uriah.
David's children began to kill one another. You said that is Old Testament. Let me bring you into the New Testament. You remember one time Jesus said, I'm going to the cross. He was teaching publicly. And my Bible says, whilst Jesus was talking, Peter stood up and began to rebuke Jesus publicly. The Bible says in Galatians chapter
1,
Paul said, I confronted Peter publicly.
Ngo nahangaye Petero imbere y'abantu.
Peter was a senior apostle.
Mwibuke Petero yari umukozi w'Imana mu rwego rwo hejuru. Paulo ni aragitangira.
But Paul publicly confronted Peter.
Ariko Paulo yahangaye Petero mu ruhame.
What Peter did brought a self-imposed curse upon him.
Ibyo Petero yakoze kuri Yesu byamuzaniye umuvumo kuri we.
Let's come to the Apostle Paul.
Reka tugaruke ku ntumwa Paul.
You remember the Apostle Paul killed Christians.
Muri we ka Paul yicaga abakristo.
He got saved.
Arakizwa.
God forgave him.
Imana iramubabarira.
He was there. He supervised the stoning of Stephen.
Hanyuma yarahagaze bica Stefano bamutera amabuye.
Three times Paul was stoned, almost to the point of death.
Paulo bamuteye amabuye.
It had to take the Christians to pray for him to come back to life.
Yasabye abakristo kumusengera kugira ngo agaruke.
In the end, Paul was martyred.
Paulo yishwe nyuma.
Am I teaching some Bible so far?
Ese ndimo ndigisha Bibiliya.
Amen mwampaye. Am I teaching some Bible?
Ese ndacyavuga Bibiliya.
So there are self-imposed curses you can bring upon yourself.
Hari imivumo wowe ubwawe ushobora kwikururira.
The Bible says,
Bibiliya iravuga ngo,
woe is he Cursed is he who puts his trust in man. So you may be a believer, born again, redeemed from the curse of the law. If you put your trust in man, you have brought yourself under a curse. Am I teaching some Bible here? The Bible says, woe is he who repays evil for good. Evil shall never depart from his house. So you can be a Christian, and if you repay evil for good, evil never departs from your house. The Bible says, whosoever despises his father and insults his mother, his light shall be put out. He shall not rise from obscurity. You can be a Christian if you insult your spiritual father or your biological father. You put out your light. You have brought a self-imposed curse upon yourself. You know, so we have Christians. We have pastors. Who have been raised by somebody. And the man who laid hands on them, taught them, raised them, prayed for them. One day they want to leave. And they paint the man a bad man. And they say all kinds of things. Most of those ministries don't succeed. Why don't they succeed? Because cursed is he who repays evil for good. And so there are many pastors. They are pastors. They are sanctified, bought by the blood. They have been redeemed from the curse of the law. But their ministries are not doing well because they have brought a self-imposed curse upon themselves.
Bituye ikibi ikiza aho kugira ngo biturikiza bituye ikibi ababagiriye neza. Niyo mpamvu imirimo y'Imana bakora ntitera imbere ntigira kwigera.
Am I teaching some Bible?
Ndacyavuga Bibiliya.
Oh, am I teaching some Bible?
Ndacyavuga Bibiliya.
Give me a believing amen.
Mumpa amen itubutse.
I told you this morning, you see, when you buy pay as you go, you top up the money. So top up your amen for me. So there are different kinds of curses. Time will not permit me to keep looking at self-imposed curses. There is the curse of bitterness. There is the curse of Satan. Beloved, there are unknown and even hidden and mysterious curses. But the Bible says in Proverbs 26 and verse 2, as the bird by wandering, as the swallow by flying, so the curse causeless shall not come. Beloved, a curse can only come upon you if you do something. And the IT guy, can you put on the screen for me Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verses 1 and 2? Deuteronomy 28 verses 1 and 2. It says, if you will listen diligently to the voice of the Lord your God, being watchful to do his commandments which I command you this day, God will set you above all the nations. Verse 2. And all these blessings shall come on you and overtake you if you heed the voice of the Lord your God. So, walking in blessings is predicated on this. Give me verses 14 and 15. Verses, it says, and you shall not turn aside from any of the words which I command you this day, to the right or to the left, to go after the other gods to serve them. But if you will not obey the voice of the Lord your God by being watchful to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command you this day, then all these curses shall come upon you and overtake you. Listen to me, beloved. Two things. Blessings can come upon you and overtake you. Curses can come upon you and overtake you. They are all based on the fact that you are obeying the word of God.
So,
if you are a Christian and you disobey the word of God, from the verse 15 to the end of that chapter, that is what we call the curse of the law. But if Christ has redeemed you from the curse of the law, look at what the Bible says in the New Testament. He says every sin is without the body. But the sin of fornication is against the body.
So
even in the New Testament, when you pollute yourself with sexual sin, you allow the devil to strike your body. That is what the Bible is saying. So you can be redeemed from under the curse of the law. If you don't hearken to obey the voice of the Lord your God, you bring yourself under a curse. If you are here with me, give me an amen. If you want to clap, please do it well. Because the problem we have as believers is some of us have an exaggerated stretch of the grace of God. We believe that under grace, God ceases to be a God who to be a just God and a God who punishes. Have you forgotten that it was under grace that Ananias and Sapphira died? It was under grace. The church had started. The Holy Spirit had come down in Acts chapter 12. Ananias and Sapphira were misbehaving. Give me an
amen.
And so, beloved, as believers, we can't just take it for granted. So quickly, let's look at some of the causes that will bring a curse upon you. Number one is disobeying the word of God. If you disobey the word of God, curses will come upon you. Number two is idolatry. Idolatry is one thing that no matter the grace you have, when you play with, you bring God's anger upon you. In Acts chapter 15, can you give me Acts chapter 15 verse 23? Acts chapter 15 verse 23. So there was confusion in some of the churches Paul planted. So they came to Jerusalem and had the apostolic council. And they said, tell the Gentiles, that includes those of us in Rwanda here in
Africa,
tell them that the apostles and brethren and the elders, this is what we are saying. Verse 24. He says, we have heard persons and the number of disturbed bringing these teachings to you.
Yes. 25.
It has been resolved by us in the assembly to select men and send them to you. 26. Men who have hazarded their lives for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we have sent Judas and Silas, who themselves will bring you the message by word of mouth. For it was good to the Holy Spirit and to us not to lay upon you any greater burden than these indispensable requirements. And what are their requirements? You jumped. Okay, God, that these indispensable requirements, what are the requirements? Yes, 29. That that you abstain from what has been sacrificed to idols, or you abstain from idolatry.
Kwirinda inyama zaterekerejwe ibishushanyo bisengwa n'amaraso y'ibinizwe no gusambana.
And from things strangled,
ibintu byanizwe,
and bloodshed,
na bisengwa n'amaraso,
and from sexual sin,
n'ubusambanyi cyangwa gusambana.
If you keep yourselves from these, you will do well.
Ibyo nibyirinda muzaba mukoze neza.
In the New Testament,
no mwisezerano rishya,
idolatry pollutes the altar of God.
Gusenga ibigirwamana bikuraho igicaniro cy'Uwiteka.
I don't know about you.
Sinzi wowe.
But in my country,
ariko mu gihugu cyanjye,
when the family meets,
iyo umuryango uhuye,
they pour libation, they invoke the ancestors,
bahamagara bakurambere,
it's idolatry,
nukuramye ibishushanyo,
any form of idolatry
buri buryo bwose bwo
kurambishushanyo,
umuvumo.
Number three,
icya gatatu,
dishonoring your parents,
kutubaha ababyeyi,
brings a curse,
bizana umuvumo.
Number four,
icya kane,
unnatural sex. What do I mean by unnatural sex? Not natural sex is sex in marriage. Any other sex outside marriage, whether adultery, whether fornication, whether homosexuality, whether incest or bestiality,
ubusambanyi bwose bukorwa usibye abakora imibonano mpuzabitsina bashakanye abandi bose abakinganye abikinisha n'abandi bose
brings a curse
bizana umuvumo.
Number five,
cya gatanu,
dealing unjustly with the weak
gukorana n'abatumvira imana.
Oh, in my country there are times a man dies and suddenly the family will come and take all his property and drive the woman away.
Yes, iwawo mu muryango ni naye wacu birahaba iyo umugabo apfuye rimwe na rimwe beno abo umugabo baraza bagahita batwara ibyo byamwe no abo byose umugore bakirukana.
Malachi 2:15 talks about not dealing unjustly with the weak.
Igitabo cya Malachi cyo kabunongo 15 ngo ntimukore ibimeze bityo.
When you deal unjustly with the weak, God will not hold you guiltless.
Ngo nimukore bidakwiriye nk'ibyo ntimuzabona imbabazi.
Number 6, trusting in man.
Icya gatandatu, kwiringira umuntu.
Jeremiah 17 verses 5 and 6. If you put your trust in man, you bring yourself under curse. Number 7. Stealing and lying. When you steal, a mobile curse follows you. Look at what the Bible says in Zechariah chapter 5. Verses 1 to 4. It says, then I turned and lifted up my eyes and looked, and behold, a flying roll. He said to me, what do you see? I said, I see a flying roll. He said, the length is 20 cubits and the breadth is 10 cubits. Verse 3, then he said, this is the curse that goes forth over the face of the whole earth. For everyone that steals shall be cut off as on this side according to it. Verse 4, I will bring it forth, says the Lord of hosts, it shall enter into the house of the thief. And into the house of him that swears falsely by my name.
No munzi urahira izina ryanjye ibinyoma.
It shall remain in his house.
Uzaba mu mazu yabo.
It will eat up the timber and it will eat up the stones thereof.
Imbere uyatwikane n'ibiti n'amabuye byayo.
When you steal,
yo wiba,
even your walls, the walls in your house and your doors, that means there's no protection. Don't forget that when the Bible talks about stealing, not fighting is also stealing. It says, you have robbed me, even this whole nation. When you don't fight, you are stealing from God. And when that happens, a mobile curse follows you. He says that curse will follow you and follow you into your house, eat your walls and eat your doors. And so you can be born again and allow curses into your life. Number 8, not honoring your vow. Malachi 1:14. Curse is the deceiver who has in his flock a male and vows and sacrifices unto the Lord, but does not present it.
ngo havumwe wari we wese udasohoza icyo yemeje kuzakora cyangwa se umuhigo yarahiye nta usohoze.
The Bible says you will decree a thing.
Bibira avuga ngo uzavuga ikintu
and it shall be established.
Kandi kizahaba.
Because you have paid your vows.
Kuko wubahirije indahiro yawe.
So you are a Christian.
Uri umukristo.
A plague is raised.
Ariko
you get up. You make a pledge.
You don't honor it.
But bringing yourself under a curse.
Hello. Hello.
In the next few minutes. So how do I break these curses? There are so many of them. But how do I break them? Number one. You repent of all your known sins. Number two, you renounce the sins of your fathers. Number three, you accept God's forgiveness and forgive yourself. Number four, you destroy all point of contacts that represent the curse. Number five, you set yourself free from the curses by violent prayer. The Bible says, since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, the violent take it by force. When I got saved, God led me to just be praying and praying and praying.
Maze gukizwa Imana yanyohereje cyangwa yanyoboye mu gusenga no gusenga no gusenga.
One time I said to the Lord,
bimwe mbwira Uwiteka,
I said, why do you lead me into all these long seasons of prayer?
Kubera icyo uhora unyohereza mu masengesho
y'udacadashira. He said, where you are coming from?
Arambwira ngo aho uturuka.
There are things that will work against you.
Hari ibintu bizaguhangara.
And so you must break those, you must break them.
Ibyo bintu ugomba kubikuraho.
And so I do most of my prayer in unknown tongues.
Lero amasengesho yanjye
nyakora. Because he who prays in an unknown tongue does not pray unto men. But praise unto God. People don't understand. The devil does not even understand. But when you pray in an unknown tongue, you are breaking things. You are pulling down strongholds. You are destroying altars. You are dealing with things. The things that the devil has erected against you. Do you know that there are things that God has for you? And the devil wished you would not get it. There are times Christians say that whatever belongs to me will come to me. It is true, but it is not true. Do you remember that there was a guy called Perez? Where we get our church's name Perez. They were twins in the womb. When they were going to be born, one brought out his hand. They tied a scarlet thread on his hand. He was supposed to be the firstborn. He drew back his hand. The other one jumped out. Perez became the firstborn. They asked him, how did you break through like that? Perez took the place of the other one. Do you remember that in the Bible? If Nathan and Bathsheba had not gone to David and said, David, but you promised that the Lord said Solomon will be king. Adonijah was taking the kingship. Listen to me, there are things that belong to you. And if you sit down, the devil will take what belongs to you. There is promotion that belongs to you. If you sit down, the devil will take what belongs to you. Have you forgotten that in Acts chapter 1, the Bible says this about Judas? When they were going to replace Judas, Peter said he was one of us, but his bishopric let another take. That means that Judas should have been one of the foundation stones in heaven. But somebody we didn't know about,
Matthias,
took his place. There are things that belong to you. And if you don't violently take them, the devil will take them
from you. I came tonight to tell somebody, whatever belongs to you that the devil has been attempting to make sure you don't get it, from tonight it will be your portion.
And
you didn't hear me. I said whatever belongs to you, that one thing or the other, you are going to miss it. From tonight it will come to you. Will you please stand? We are going to use the next 5 minutes to talk to God. We are going to pray. We are going to bring down every plan of the enemy against your life. David said in Psalm 144 and verse 1, he said, God is the one who teaches my hands to walk and my fingers to fight. You have got to understand how to fight for what belongs to you. Lift up your hand and say this after me. In the name of Jesus, whatever belongs to me tonight, I come by the power in the blood and I claim what belongs to me. It shall not pass me by. I will receive my promotion. I will receive my favor. I receive my increase. I receive my promotion. The raising of my head from today, my church is growing. From today, my business is growing. Whatever is stopping my marriage, from today, I break it now. Whatever is stopping my childbearing, from today, I break it now. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Open your mouth. Talk to God. 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 Open your mouth. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Take authority. Take authority. Over any curse pronounced against you in the name of Jesus. Ask God to remove any curse that came on you through disobeying his word. Command any demon attached to any curse to depart from you in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Talk to him now. Talk to him now. Talk to him now. Talk to him now. Talk to God. Pray that all curses pronounced against you will turn to blessings. Break the curse of failure and defeat. Break the curse of failure. Break the curse of mental and physical sickness. Break the curse of oppression. Break the curse of family breakup. Break the curse of bad reputation. Break it now. Break the curse of personal destruction and suicide. Break it now. And tonight, claim uncommon success. Claim your promotion. Ask that you will not fail. You will not fall in life. Break any power maintaining any curse in your life, any limitation in your life. In the name of Jesus, every disappointment of your expectation, in the name of Jesus, that it be broken tonight by the power of the Holy Ghost. 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 In Jesus' name. Will you please take your seats for a few minutes? Take your seats for a few minutes. Listen to me. Listen to me. Under an anointing like this, under a meeting like this, is the best time to sow a seed.
I said in a meeting like this, it's the best time to sow a seed. Your pastor didn't tell me to take an offering. But I'm going to take an offering. Because to host a meeting like this, it takes money to host a meeting like this. Hey, you didn't hear me. Give me an amen.
Amen.
And listen, proof that you love God
garagaza ko ukunda Imana
is how much you sacrifice for him.
Ni uburyo witanga kubwe.
First Kings chapter 3.
Abami wa mbere gice cya
gatatu. The Bible says Solomon loved the Lord.
Yero ngo Salomoni yakunda
guhiteka. And he gave 1,000 burnt offerings.
Ngo atanga ibitambo
bihumbi.
Ngo yakunda guhiteka.
And you see the joy of it.
Umunezero wabyo.
Is that God is such that when your sacrifice speaks, it changes things in your life. When Solomon loved the Lord and he proved it by sacrificing, God now said, Solomon, what do you want?
Tonight,
there's somebody sow a seed that will change things in your life. I remember in 2008, when we were building our dome. We needed to do the roof. It was
going
to cost us about $1 million
and something dollars.
And Dr. Cerulo visited us.
I said
to my board,
said,
this man, let's sow a seed in his life.
We need a
breakthrough. In this meeting that he has come to hold here, let's sow a seed. We took $50,000 and sold into the ministry. That same week, somebody walked up to me, gave me the first $100,000 I've ever received.
You didn't hear me.
Within the twinkle of an eye, the roof had come on.
Listen to me.
Tonight, there is an anointing here. I want you to sow a sacrificial seed. Time will not permit me to share testimonies to you of simple, ordinary people in our church that sow sacrificial seeds. And today, what God has done in their lives. In our church, the floor space is 7,874 square meters.
Mwitorero ryabo asengeramo igipimo cy'itorero aho abantu bicara nibyo bipimo yavuze.
One person tiled it but all the tiles.
Niwe washize amakaro aho ngaho.
When he started coming to the church, he had one small house.
Aza mwitorero ryacu yarafite inzu imwe akazu gato.
Today he builds houses.
Uyu munsi yubaka amazu.
Amen.
Amen.
Today he builds houses.
Uyu munsi yubaka amazu.
Our line arrays. Cost us $176,000. A gentleman who started coming to the church in slippers.
Umusore wabikoze yatangiye kuza mu rusengero yambaye kamambiri.
We raised an offering.
Buruko dutanze ituro.
He will give a sacrificial offering.
Agatanga ikintu kimugoye.
Today he has 5 companies.
Uyu munsi afite company 5.
The day we wanted to buy the speakers,
igihe twashaka kugura ibyo indangururamajwi,
I will pay for it.
Yabwiye ngo Bishop nzabigura.
Pay for it.
Arabyishyura. Mwihute.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of
Nazareth,
I pray that as your people honor their
way,
you will honor them.
Nawe
in Jesus' name.
Mwizina rya Yesu Kristo.
God bless you.
Imana ibahe umugisha.
I just did the introduction of release me.
Na koze ndavuga ibirebana
curses to blessings.
Kuva mu mufumo ujya mu mugisha icyo gitabo kirahari.
I came with just a few books.
Nazanye ibitabo bitari byinshi.
They are at the book table outside.
Biri hanze ku meza.
Take advantage of them.
Ushatse wagira ibyo ugura.
One of them is money in your pocket.
Kimwe kivuga ku mafaranga mu mufuka wawe.
This will show you how to invest, how to pay your debt.
uburyo wakwishyura
amadeni, showing the steps to take to pay your debt, how to save, the discipline to say oh,
uburyo wakwizigamira,
it will change your life. Money in your pocket,
amafaranga mu mufuka wawe.
Terrorists of leadership,
abayobozi batwiterabwoba.
And then there are books in French,
hari bitabo mfite mu gifaransa,
from small to medium to mega, how to grow your church,
uburyo umurimo w'Imana ukora wakura itorero ryakura.
Power in prayer,
imbaraga z'amasengesho.
Taking your blessings by force is in French,
uburyo umugisha ugomba kutwara kugahato.
Evangelism, crusade planning and church planting,
uburyo twashinga amatorero.
Every pastor must get some for his
members.
Impact of prayer,
uburyo amasengesho afite imbaraga.
And every church leader or church worker needs this, rooted and built up in him.
Buri mushumba cyangwa se umuntu ukora mu itorero akeneye kiriho gitabo.
The book table,
iri hanze ku meza.
If I have time, I will sign it for you.
Mbonya kanya na
bifuza. But will you welcome the apostle of the house?
Reka twakire
umubyeyi. With the mighty club offering, put your hands together, receive apostle Masasu.
Dukomere Imana amashyi twakire umubyeyi wacu.
With the mighty club offering.
Mu izina rya Yesu Kristo.